spaces in said the soil. The second point, in all truth, they have lenticels that take place, that act as sites for gaseous exchange. In roots, gaseous exchange takes place in the diffusion of the epidermal cells in the soil. The second point is, in older roots, we have lenticels that act as site for gaseous exchange. We also have, when soil is waterlogged, the air spaces are blocked and air is not able to reach in the roots. This may lead the plants to die or the roots.
These are plants that live underwater. These plants need also to breathe. Therefore, they extend their roots outwards in order for them to exchange gases, for gaseous exchange to take place. We have a diagram that shows how the aquatic plants breathe. And this is the diagram.
This is the water. These are the breathing roots. Also, the aquatic plants. Their roots will extend upwards in order for them to exchange, for gaseous exchange to take place. This is where the gaseous exchange takes place. That's all about the gaseous exchange in roots, stem, and leaves. So I leave it up to my colleague, Michelle, to take you on gaseous exchange in animals.
So first, there is the unicellular and simple organisms have a large surface area to volume ratio for simple diffusion of gases, for example, the amoeba and earthworm. Then there are types of respiratory surfaces in animals. For example, the first one is cell membrane that live on water, and an example is amoeba. Another one is gill filaments that live on water, and an example is fish. Then we have the tracheals that is air, and an example is insects. Then there's the alveoli or lungs that live in the air. And an example is mammals, birds, frogs, and reptiles. Then you have the skin that live on water and air. And an example is frog, earthworm. We then have the buccal cavity that is in air. And an example is frog. Then we have the characteristics of respiratory surfaces. And these are, they must have a large surface area for simple diffusion of gases. There must be a moist surface for dissolving of gases, then should pose a rich capillary network, and the last one is must be a thin membrane. I'll now leave it to Tiffany to explain the gaseous exchange in protozoa.
Okay, in protozoa, this is a simple organism, so simple diffusion takes place. Example of a protozoa inside a cell. This is the structure of our protozoa. This structure is, we're trying to show how gaseous exchange takes place in the amoeba. So here, this is the nucleus. Then we have these arrows direct that oxygen is entering and carbon 4 oxide is coming out. We have come to the end of our discussion. I have been Tiffany McKenna,
Michelle Gadoni,
Michelle Tito.
Keep it Elimu TV, where we watch and learn.